How venomous is a black mamba compared to other snakes? There are over 3,000 different species of snake in the world, and somewhere around 10% of them are venomous. Of the venomous snakes, only about half could be a threat to the life of a human. And one of the top snakes on that list is the black mamba. His deadly reputation precedes him, a famous killer of men and animals alike. But where does the black mamba rank among all venomous snakes? Is he the worst snake for you to come across? Or is there much worse out there? Subscribe and like the video for immunity to venomous bites and for updates. Black Mamba. The Black Mamba is one of the most dangerous snakes you could cross paths with, and that's for a number of reasons. One, you guessed it, it's that lethal venom. When measuring the toxicity of a snake's venom, scientists use the median lethal dose. That is the dose required to kill half the members of a tested population. The lower the median lethal dose number, the more increased the toxicity is. And when measuring the subcutaneous injection of the median lethal dose, meaning when the venom is injected into the fatty layer beneath the skin, the black mamba's bite measures at 0.28 milligrams per kilogram. That's low. That's dangerous. It's estimated that about 10 to 15 milligrams would kill a human adult. A bite from a black mamba delivers 120 milligrams on average. It could even deliver up to 400 milligrams. The black mamba's bite has a 100% fatality rate if left untreated. Time is of the essence. You have 7 to 15 hours after a black mamba bite before you die from the effects. But within 45 minutes, paralysis can set in. We're not done yet. The black mamba can reach 14 feet in length, making it the second longest venomous snake in the world. And his ability to move up to 12 miles per hour makes him the fastest venomous snake in the world. You take all that and wrap it up together, and that is why people label the black mamba as Africa's deadliest snake. But do any snakes outrank him in venom? King Cobra. Another one of the most famous venomous snakes in the world is the King Cobra. For good reason, he's the only one longer than the Black Mamba. The longest venomous snake in the world, the King Cobra, can reach lengths of 18 feet long. He lives in the forests and plains of Southeast Asia and has a bad reputation. It's not unfair. He's dangerous, especially when he feels threatened. He's an extremely defensive snake. However, his subcutaneous median lethal dose is about 1.8 milligram per kilogram. Not quite as strong as that of the black mamba. But here's the kicker. He produces one of the highest volumes of venom in a single bite. Somewhere between 350 and 500 milligrams should be expected from a king cobra bite. Wondering if that's enough to do you in? It's enough to do an elephant in. The black mamba may be more venomous, but the king cobra is producing higher volumes of it. Indian cobra. Another cobra of the world is the Indian cobra. The Indian cobra is unique because he is part of a group of snakes known as the Big Four. The snakes in the Big Four are responsible for causing the most medically significant snake bites on the Indian subcontinent, as well as the vast majority of all bites here. Somewhere around 50,000 people in India die every year from snake bites, and about 90% of them come from the Big Four. The Indian cobra is one of this deadly gang, and he is perhaps the most iconic of them all due to his appearance and his place in Hindu culture and folklore. However, his subcutaneous median lethal dose is about 0.8 milligram per kilogram. Worse than the king cobra, not quite as bad as the black mamba. But his 160 to 250 milligram venom yield per bite is nothing to sneeze at. He's not in the Big Four for no reason. Russell's Viper. Another member of the Big Four is Russell's Viper. Russell's Viper is known to have one of the most excruciatingly painful bites of any snake. It often results in internal bleeding. Russell's Viper must be the most hated snake in all of India, as he is the snake responsible for the most deaths in the country. 25,000 fatalities a year on average. Russell's Viper accounts for about 43% of all snake-related deaths here. The subcutaneous medium lethal dose from a Russell's Viper is 0.75 milligram per kilogram, comparable to the Indian cobra, a little worse. Still not as bad as the black mamba. He also yields between 130 to 250 milligrams of venom per bite. Though the Russell's Viper is responsible for the most deaths in all of India, he still isn't the snake responsible for the most deaths in all. That would be another member of the Big Four. Common Crate. Another deadly venomous snake is the common crate. He too is part of the Big Four, ranging across most of the Indian subcontinent. The common crate is often referred to as the most dangerous snake in India, and interestingly, he has a quality about him that is completely different from Russell's viper. His bite is actually not always all that painful, which leads to false reassurance in his victims. The bite doesn't hurt so bad. Oftentimes, people shrug it off, but the lack of pain does not indicate a lack of venom. His venom contains powerful neurotoxins which induce muscle paralysis. And once the paralysis sets in, the fact that the common crate's bite contains many presynaptic neurotoxins, that means that antivenom doesn't always do the job. It needs to be administered before paralysis in most cases. This is why the common crate is so dangerous. Deception. He is responsible for around 10,000 deaths every year in India alone. However, he still is not the member of the Big Four responsible for the most deaths overall. Sorecaled Viper. We've reached the snake responsible for the most human fatalities every single year. The sorecaled viper. He's responsible for somewhere around 5,000 fatalities a year in India, but his presence is widespread throughout much of Asia and the Middle East, so his numbers skyrocket beyond any other snake's death toll. Thousands upon thousands die from this extremely aggressive snake. The subcutaneous median lethal dose of a sorecaled viper is also around 0.5 milligrams per kilogram, just like Russell's viper, and he produces an average of about 18 milligrams per bite, his maximum around 72 milligrams. Neither of those come close to the Black Mamba. So, what is it about the Big Four that make them so deadly? They are deadly and they are venomous, even if they aren't as venomous as the Black Mamba. But a lot of their death toll has to do with the fact that they live in the most densely packed regions on Earth. The fact that they overlap with such high human population is a recipe for disaster. Too many opportunities to strike, and so they do. So, can any venomous snakes out there outdo the Black Mamba? Tiger Snake. Add tiger to anything, and you know it's dangerous. From the tiger itself to the tiger shark, and yes, even to the tiger snake. You can find tiger snakes throughout much of southern Australia, but do you really want to find them? They're about 4 feet long and highly venomous. Tiger snakes are responsible for about 3,000 reported snake bites in all of Australia. Not so many fatalities occur, though, due to the fact that tiger snakes live in areas with excellent access to effective antivenom. Thank goodness for that antivenom. The subcutaneous median lethal dose is about 0.13 milligram per kilogram, compared to the Black Mamba's 0.28 milligram per kilogram. Remember, the lower the number, the more toxic. The venom contains potent neurotoxins, coagulants, hemolysins, and myotoxins. Victims could feel numbness, pain in the foot and neck region, rapid breathing difficulties, and paralysis. Most commonly, death and paralysis can happen between 6 and 24 hours from the time of the bite. It's one of the worst bites from a venomous snake on the planet. Luckily, it gets treated quickly in most cases. Banded Crate. A flashy-looking snake is the banded crate, but those flashes of black and yellow aren't just to look cool. It's a warning. This snake is found throughout much of Southeast Asia, and his venom is devastating. Even worse than the tiger snake, a subcutaneous median lethal dose of 0.11 milligram per kilogram, and he produces around 20 to 114 milligrams every bite. Sure, the maximum volume of venom the banded crate produces is around just the average of what the Black Mamba does, but the banded crate lives by the saying, a little goes a long way. If bitten by a banded crate, people will likely experience abdominal pain, vomiting, respiratory failure, and a lot of other unpleasant things. All those awful symptoms could begin between 1 to 6 hours after the bite, and anywhere from 12 to 30 hours after. The person is at extreme risk of dying, if not treated. Coastal Taipans. If you hear the word taipan, you should be shivering in your boots. The coastal taipan is a nightmare. He's about 6.6 feet long, making him the second longest venomous snake in Australia. If you were trying to avoid the tiger snake in southern Australia, sorry, the coastal taipan is native to northern and eastern Australia. It's tough to catch a break on this continent. For a coastal taipan, the subcutaneous median lethal dose is 0.9 milligrams per kilogram. We've dropped below 0.1. This is beyond deadly. There is a story of a man in Queensland who was stacking wood outside, and he was bitten by a coastal taipan through his boots and thick socks. Within 15 minutes, he was feeling nauseous and was having difficulty breathing. He was rushed to a hospital and treated, and thankfully, since it was quick enough, he made it. He still wasn't discharged from the hospital for 19 days, and he wound up losing his sense of smell after the ordeal. Treatment is essential, and it needs to be done timely. But even though the coastal taipan is terrifying, this taipan is only the third most venomous snake in the world. Eastern brown snake. Australians, we are so very sorry. We know you're looking for somewhere to run, but the eastern brown snake is not only present in eastern Australia, but as you likely fled to central Australia, well, he is there too. The eastern brown snake is typically between 5 to 6 feet long, but sometimes they can even reach 8 feet in length. And he is the snake responsible for more deaths in Australia than any other snake. The venom is insane. The subcutaneous median lethal dose is 0.05 milligram per kilogram. And though they're releasing somewhere between 4 and 65 milligrams per bite, and that may seem like a smaller amount, not very much is needed. You can die within just a few hours from an eastern brown snake bite. In fact, some have died within 30 minutes. That's got to be the worst in the world, right? Incorrect. The eastern brown snake is only the second most venomous snake in the world. Inland taipan. Remember how we told you that the word taipan should have you scared? Because not only is one taipan, the coastal taipan, number 3 on the list of most venomous snakes in the world, but number 1 is the inland taipan. Australia, our sincerest apologies. This guy inhabits many areas of central and eastern Australia. And if it isn't bad enough that he's the most venomous, he's also specially adapted to hunting warm-blooded mammals, meaning his venom works on humans superbly. If bitten and untreated, you can die in a couple of hours or in 30 minutes. The subcutaneous median lethal dose is 0.25 milligram per kilogram. One bite has enough lethality to kill more than 100 full-grown adult humans. The dose it delivers is somewhere between 44 milligrams to 110 milligrams. Sure, the black mamba has him beat in volume, as he does when compared to many snakes, but when we are talking about the strength of the venom, no one compares to the inland taipan. As you can see, some snakes are known to be killers because they live among large populations of people. Some deliver huge volumes of venom in a single bite. Some have fast-acting venom, some just have extremely potent venom. The black mamba is a special blend of many of these things, thus making him extremely lethal in every sense of the word. But always remember, the scariest word in the English language is taipan.